Dear respected nomination, hear my voice as I am speaking to you today on the 13th of August 2021 as Gau PSM Cooper, in the name of the unified body of the Nama Gaugu, namely the Nama Traditional Leaders Association, better known as NTLA. As you know, the NTLA has been following the issue of the Nama and Obaherero genocide since its inception from the parliamentary motion and resolution of 2006 to the negotiations that ensued between the special envoys of the Namibian and German governments. In this process, we have consistently held the view that the Nama and Obaherero people, through their traditional leaders, who are appointed through Nama and Obaherero customary laws, must be the drivers of any negotiations with the Federal Republic of Germany. However, we noted that the Namibian and German governments have chosen to make us consulting advisors to an agenda unknown to us. Our agenda as Nama leaders is very clear. The German government committed genocide against the Nama and Obaherero people and therefore must take full legal responsibility for the horrific crime it committed against our people, who remain homeless and voiceless in the current political setup. The responsibility of the Namibian government is to support us, the Nama and Obaherero people, who are citizens of Namibia, in our call for justice of a crime committed against our humanity. Instead, the Namibian government has chosen to work against us in cohorts with the German government, and therefore chose to speak on our behalf without our prior informed consent. In this way, the Namibian and German government have excluded us from a matter that is about us, because we refused to subscribe to the diplomatic bilateral framework that was worked out by the two governments. We made our position known to the Namibian president during a meeting held in 2017, led by the late P.C. Rukoro, may his soul rest in peace, and Gaup David Friedrich, may his soul also rest in peace. Both are deceased. Ever since, we have the principal position that unless we are on the table and talk on behalf of our people, we do not accept any thing about us without us. Without having any answers from the highest office of the Namibia, 4 years later, we now hear of a dubious campaign launched by a team of Nama-speaking parliamentarians to restore trust in the ill-fated government process, which is determined to silence our voices. The Namibian and German governments lost the trust of the Nama and Obaherero people due to a lack of transparency in the failed and shamed negotiations between the two governments. I am speaking today to the Nama nation so that they all note that parliamentarians presenting themselves as mothers and daughters of the Nama people and holding meetings with traditional councillors and community leaders in order to persuade and coach them to support the government process which has sold out the interests of the Nama and Obaherero people. The parliamentarian ladies who happen to be my daughters visiting the Nama communities do not present themselves as official delegates of the Namibian government, but rather present themselves as apparently caring mothers and daughters of the Nama people. I raise my voice today to caution you, the Nama people, because there seems to be a deliberate agenda to divide the Nama and Ovaherero people. To the Namibian president, I make once again this public call. I am only a phone call away. Stop sending messengers to my people. Pick up your phone and call me, since you do not answer my letters to you. To the German president, I say, we will hold you accountable for the grave intergenerational trauma the colonial German state and the Federal Republic of Germany as its successor have placed on the Nama and Ovaherero people. I thank you.